Good morning. I was going to say, you guys are public health students. I expect a better response than that. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay. So anyways, my name is Joseph Korevec. I am the Director of Admissions and Financial Aid. I want to welcome you here today. I have so far in the last hour or so since I've started seeing some of the students coming in, I've heard some harrowing stories about your adventure to New York City. So once again, I want to thank you. One of the things I do in my job is manage expectations. So for those folks who come from warmer climates, I want to let you know that yes, it does get cold here from time to time in New York City. So you'll have to deal with that. So anyways, welcome to New York City and the Columbia University Mailman School of Public Health. As I said before, many of you have traveled great distances through the cold and snow to be with us today. We want to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to choose to be with us today. Before I begin, I would like to publicly acknowledge my team. Betsy Asher, whose tireless efforts have made this event possible. Julie, who made sure your applications got to the faculty members for review. And Farrah and Charles, who are actually back in the office doing appointments, who helped put your financial aid packages together. I am very proud to be a member of such a hardworking and dedicated team. Let's give them a round of applause. Okay, so rather than tell you about the Columbia experience, I want to show you a quick video.
I went to Malawi. I was working with kids who have HIV.
I went to a small high altitude city in Peru. I was working with the maternal child health project.
Whether it's an emergency situation or a stable one, the practicum's a really great opportunity for students to get hands-on experience in a research area that they're interested in.
Two days before I arrived in Sierra Leone, the first case of Ebola was confirmed. I was essentially an intern with the International Rescue Committee and was originally going to Sierra Leone to work on a reproductive health project, but it was a very quick shift into working on Ebola. I was representing IRC on the Kenema District Task Force, which was comprised of the Ministry of Health, UNICEF, the WHO, and the World Food Program. At the beginning of the outbreak, many of the NGOs, including IRC, did not have specific funding for emergency response services. And so the British High Commissioner and the Irish Ambassador to Sierra Leone came out to Kenema, and I was asked to host them. It was kind of a surprise to be in an emergency response setting, and it was, a little scary. But I really couldn't have asked for a more intense and educational experience.
John is a perfect example of a typical Mailman student who wasn't surprised by any of the challenges that he faced. He was really well equipped to shift gears and ask the right questions and listen. Those combined skills really made him a perfect fit for that situation.
Dr. Moreski's absolutely brilliant. She's an emergency medicine physician. She's managing multiple programs internationally.
I started a program called SIDHEART, looking at how to bridge the gap in acute care or emergency services in rural sub-Saharan Africa. Mailman is unique. We're constantly using the work we do in the field to inform our teaching. And a perfect example is Wafa Sadr. Wafa is a world-renowned infectious disease physician, the director of ICAP, and a great leader in global health.
Our students are given a lens through which to understand the world and develop public health solutions that is interdisciplinary, that goes from the science to practice, and positions them to lead for the next 50 years of their career.
Okay. So as you can see from the video, we want to prepare you to be leaders in the field of public health. We want to prepare you to be well-equipped to shift gears if necessary. We want to prepare you to ask the right questions. We want to prepare you for careers that have not been invented yet. For the last 3 months, the admissions committee has reviewed thousands of applications, and we chose you. We chose you because we believe that you could benefit from the Columbia experience. I know we made the right choice. You have accomplished more in 25 to 30 years than most people accomplish in an entire lifetime. We are very proud of our choice. Now it's your turn. You must make a choice that will impact the rest of your life. Today, we will provide you with information so that you can make a well-informed choice. We will tell you about our unique curriculum, a curriculum that you will not find at any other school of public health. We will show you what it's like to be a student at Mailman. We will offer you a glimpse into some of your career opportunities. You will have a chance to talk with students, faculty, and staff. We want you to ask questions. Ask lots of questions. At the end of the day, we hope you choose the Columbia University Mailman School of Public Health for your graduate work. Whether you choose Columbia or not, I applaud you for choosing public health. I truly believe that your future, my future, and the future of the world depends on talented individuals like yourself choosing public health as a career. Thank you again. In order to start you on that decision process, it gives me great pleasure to introduce Dr. Marlyn Delva. Dr. Delva is the Associate Dean and Dean of Students and lecturer in the Department of Epidemiology. In addition, she is a good friend and a colleague. At this time, I would like to welcome Dr. Marlyn Delva.
Thanks, Joe, and good morning. It is really my pleasure to welcome you to the Mailman School. What I've been tasked to do as the Dean of Students here is to provide you with some of the key information that you're going to need as you think through, is this the right fit? As Joe said, you have to make a choice. This is no longer undergraduate where you're trying to find yourself and figure out what you're being called to do. This is graduate school, and you made a choice based on what we believe is a calling into public health. Because you're not going into public health for the millions of dollars you're going to make or the six-figure salary with potential. You're going into public health because you believe that there are injustices in this world, that we as people, as human beings, and as individuals need to work collectively in order to improve, in order to ameliorate, and hopefully completely obliterate. And so with that, you're coming because you are angry. You're angry with the way the world is. You're angry with the health disparities that exist. You're angry with the fact that health is not a human right any longer. And you need to move it to a place where it is a human right, a universal one. Not one with the countries that only have universal health care. Not one that believes in debating whether you should have universal health care. But one where it's a right for each individual to be able to thrive as healthy people. So with that, I'm going to take a few minutes this morning to talk to you about who's sitting next to you. The students that you'll be engaged in academic discourse if you were to choose the Mailman Advantage. We're gonna start with providing with a snapshot of this morning's conversation. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the students, but I'm also gonna tell you, spend some time demonstrating to you what our students are engaged in as public health students at the Mailman School. You're gonna hear a lot about what you're gonna do in the classroom. What we wanna show you though is what is outside of the classroom and applying the theories and the concepts that you're being taught in class to real life public health issues and complex public health problems. We are going to spend some time listening from our Dean of Career Services, who's going to tell you a little bit about their resource, but also the most important question, what do you do with this? What is this tangibly going to look like for you as a graduate? And then we're going to break you up into groups to talk to you about the degree that you're pursuing. And those of you who will be staying here with me, I'm going to take some time to really walk you through the Columbia MPH program. Okay? So let me get started with the overview of the student body and student life. So who are our students? This is, again, a snapshot of the fall 2014. We educated close to 1,500 students. As you'll see, the majority of them are pursuing our MPH, about 80% of the class. But you can also see that we have a number of students pursuing across our six academic departments the additional degrees that we offer, and that you'll hear more about depending on your interest. Our median age of the fall incoming class for the MPH, which is the largest degree-seeking program, was about 25 years old. And the older groups, as you can see, are in our executive and doctoral programs. We are 75% women strong, but we're very thrilled at the 25% men that we have here. We're very excited, and I see quite a few of them, so we're going to try to make sure you come to increase those numbers. Because we believe in diversity, and so bringing men enhances our diversity, but it is a commitment that we have here at the school. And as you can see in this slide here, we are truly committed in having a class that's representative of the communities in which we work and the field in which we want to continue to enhance and develop. Where do our students come from? Again, the fall 2014 class came from 39 of the 50 United States. Joe's mission is to get to all 50, so we're doing our best to do that, and 36 countries, nations. Now, the piece that I really wanted to share with you are how our students engage outside of the Mailman classroom. We have 21, and it keeps growing, active student organizations. These organizations are student-led, and we support students taking initiative to really bring the issues and the complex problems of public health to our doorsteps, for us to address them, for us to think about them, for us to solve them together, by taking what they're learning in the classroom and really applying it to the practice of public health. And so our students do that. And through their student leadership and organizations, they host events, such as you saw with the video, taking a stand against Ebola, participating in the climate march, having an important forum discussing the race relations here in this country with the police non-indictments. We held over 80 student events. And I'm going to give you a splattering of some of what those events look like. From a graduate festival where we had students from all across the 17 schools and programs at the university come together to network. We had experiential leadership training. Our students did a service day through a perspective on aging program. And I wanted to show you, to bring it to life, that it's not just simply even in the events where we're sitting in a very academic stance, but students have fun here too. And so while cleaning up a local park, you see some of our top faculty members in the annual Hike the Heights event. All of these folks in orange, and maybe a different color, you'll see them in the fall, are students who've taken the time to make sure that you who are coming in August have a great experience from the moment you hit our front steps. And so students are invested in their peers, in their colleagues, in ensuring that the experience you have here is one that from the get-go is a wonderful one. These are, again, images from the climate march, images from that important and critical emergency conversation. And what is also something that you need to keep in mind and recognize that we are doing here as a School of Public Health, from our faculty to our students, is engaging with the community. Being in Washington Heights, we can't ignore where we are and the work that we have to do. And so our students brought for a community day a number of community organizations to showcase what they are working with, their missions and goals, and ways in which our students and our faculty can be engaged in those prospects. So what I've given you is a snapshot of who is going to be in the classroom with you. You come from all walks of life. You can see the age range, you see the demographics, you see the diversity in the class. And what you also have just experienced is a little bit of what students are engaged in. What are they participating in? What are some of the conversations that they're having? Where we don't have a static curriculum, that if things are happening in current events, that we're not talking about it. When I'll talk to you a little bit about the MPH, you're going to hear on how a course quickly changed to speak about Ebola and to think through what can we do as a school. The vaccination crisis and controversy. Professors immediately put that into their curriculum to talk about, well, what can we do? Where is public health? Where is public health during these race relations conversations? Where is public health as we think about health as a human right? And so as you can see, we are dynamic. We're dynamic in our engagement as a student body, and we're dynamic in our engagement as a faculty to ensure that our students are leaving here with the education that they need. So what I'm going to shift gears a little bit and introduce Heather Krasna, who is the Dean of Career Services, who's going to talk to you a little bit about the other elements of your educational endeavor here, which is thinking about what do I do with this degree and how do I really make it come to life. Heather?